Hi, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good days, everyone. It's so nice to see you again. Welcome to join our program today. And I'm very grateful that you have been watching our program. This is our seventh time. Wow, seven times is a long time. And well, it's really an honor that I can host this program for you. And I hope you really can benefit from this program and you can spread this information to all your friends. Let more people join our Ping Shui Workout online courses. And today we are going to talk about Ping Shui and insomnia. Well, a lot of people have this kind of sleeping problem. And one out of 10 people cannot sleep well during nighttime. I don't know if you are. Well, if you have sleeping problem, maybe sleep less or you cannot fall asleep easily, then you can take one on our online course. Then let us know how many people who are watching our show have this kind of sleeping problem. And you know the sleeping pills we have been eating, well, it's longer than one superhighway in Taiwan. So the sleeping pills cost a lot. So today we are going to talk about how Ping Shui work with people who have sleeping problem. And we have invited Dr. Zhang Zhihong, and he specialized in Chinese medicine. So now let's welcome today's guest, Zhang Zhihong. Take a seat, say hello to everybody.
Hello, everybody.
Good. Okay, take a seat. Now, I know that Dr. Zhang, he was born in a family specialized in Chinese medicine, and he specialized in medicine technology. So look at this picture. I don't know what you are doing in this picture. What is medical technology? What are you doing?
Okay. 我在做医疗跟物联网连在一起。 然后帮助偏乡的人医疗品质提升。
So what he is doing in this picture, he is using technology and bring medical resources to counties, far away counties, maybe on the top of the mountain or places where medical resources or doctor is not easy to get there. So they use internet to bring medical resources to those countries so people can take advantage of a doctor's advice through internet. Well, that's a great thing you are doing.
Yes.
Yes. I understand that you was born in a Chinese drugstore. 他是中医第二代. Your father is a person who take care of Chinese drugstore, right?
Right. 是的.
So what brings you into the field of Chinese medicine? 你为什么会走上中医?
Okay. 是的. 好, 分享两个故事. 第一个呢, 就是我小时候, 4岁的时候, 有气喘病.
He has asthma when he was young.
Yeah. 然后我两个礼拜就生病一次。
Yeah, so he has to go to doctor twice, not twice, every 2 weeks.
Yes.
Every two weeks.
那我父亲教我两个方法把我的气喘病练好了。
So his father taught him two ways to cure his asthma.
第一个方法呢, 他教我深呼吸。
One is the breathing control, 吐纳, a kind of qigong.
第二个方法就是教我用中药的方法调我的体质。
So the second is using the Chinese medicine. Yeah.
那第二件事情呢, 是我妹妹呢, 发烧不退, 哎, 然后医生西医, 束手无策。
Yeah, so his first experience is on himself. And the second experience about Chinese medicine is about his sister. His sister had high fever.
那我父亲就用中药就帮我妹退烧了。
Yeah, so the doctor in the hospital couldn't do anything at all. So eventually, his father used the Chinese medicine and helped his sister recover from the high fever. So these two experiences brought him into the interest in Chinese medicine.
Yeah.
So today we are going to talk about insomnia. So let's ask Dr. Zhang, what is the causes of insomnia? How come people cannot sleep well? The causes. Well, you can look at this picture.
我要介绍一下我们失眠的真正的 root cause， 一定要有分 inside the problem 跟 outside 的部分。
Mm-hmm. Now you got it. Inside and outside problem. Good.
好，那我们看一下第一个影响我们失眠的是心。好，我们的心。
Oh, heart. Heart.
心。
The first is your heart.
心。好，在中医来讲，心有情绪的部分，那也有血液循环的部分。
Well, the heart is connected with your emotion, and also it affect your blood circulation.
是。那第二个呢，就是讲到我们的肝。
The second is your liver. So these are the organs that causes the problem with your sleep. So the second is liver.
肝负责全身血液的循环，当我们情绪有波动的时候，就会影响我们全身的血液循环。
So liver is in charge of the blood circulation of your whole body. So if you have emotional disturbance, then it will affect your blood circulation.
所以心跟肝都是影响我们 inside the problem.
Yeah, so the heart and liver is really the inside problem that causes the insomnia.
那介绍完失眠的 inside， 我们讲一下外部的影响。第一个呢，就是我们的脾胃。
Well, so the outside influences comes through the stomach, the spleen and stomach problem.
举个例子啊，我们饮食吃得太饱或刺激性的食物，都会影响我们晚上睡眠。
Well, if you eat too much, well, it will affect your sleep definitely.
是的。那第四个呢，就是肾
，kidney， your kidney。
那在中医特别讲到肾，原因是因为在睡眠的时候，我们肾跟心，一个是水，一个是火，那我们要平衡。
Well, in Chinese medicine, we say that the heart is fire, kidney is water. Water and fire needs to be balanced.
是，待会会有一个图来解释。
Okay, so.The outside influence and inside problem, and the causes of insomnia is connected with these organs: your heart, your liver, your stomach, and your kidney. Okay, now let's talk about what's the symptom of insomnia connected with these five organs. What's the symptom?
Okay, 在中医来讲，第一个影响的呢就是心
，heart，
心。那有什么症状呢？第一个症状就是心烦。
Well, if your insomnia is connected with your heart, and the symptom comes out will be you feel irritated, you feel so nervous.
然后容易口干。
Yeah, and you feel thirsty all the time, dryness inside your mouth.
所以这种情况你睡眠是睡不好的，不安稳的。
Yeah, yeah. So if you have this kind of problem caused by your fire in your heart, you cannot sleep well.It's the fire. You have fire in your heart. Yes. And what about the second one, the liver? Liver.
The second, 就是我们的肝。
Liver.
那肝刚才讲到负责全身的血液循环。
The liver take care of the blood circulation over your body.
是。那在中医来讲，情绪只要影响到，好，我们的身体血液循环就会变差。
Okay, so if your sleeping problem is caused by your liver, and you will have this kind of symptoms such as easily irritated, easily get angry.
是。
Yeah.
所以我们特别提醒大家，回家下班回家之后，是不是有带情绪回家呢？
Yeah. So, doctor, remind you that if you work and you go home, please do not bring the problem in your office back home. You need to put that away. Yes. So,
okay.
So if you have this liver problem, you cannot sleep well and you will dream a lot, right? Dream a lot.
是。
Yeah. And what about the third one? Is the heart and stomach problem altogether?
是。这是中医特别讲到的心跟脾的问题。心脾两虚就是有跟我们的外因有关，跟饮食也有关系。
Okay, so if you have a heart and the stomach problem, it always causes by what you eat and how you eat. It's the outside influence.
那最主要症状呢，就是会觉得身体重重的。
Well, then you will feel that your body is so heavy.
疲倦。
Feel tired.
那这个很多呢，就跟吃很多的冰有关咯。
Well, that's probably because you ate a lot of ice.
对，那因为身体也是有湿气的。
Yes, because if you put in too much icy stuff, then the wetness will stay inside your body.
是。
Yes, so the symptom of insomnia, you can decide what kind of symptom you have. Then you will know the main causes is whether it's heart, it's liver, or it's your stomach problem. Then you will have a basic idea about what's going wrong. So from Chinese medicine, we have some kind of theory to treat insomnia, right?就是中医如何来对治这个失眠问题呢？
是
用什么样的原理？
是，那我从这边开始呢，就要从中医对应到最简单的阴阳平衡开始说起。
So Chinese medicine, they treat insomnia problem with the idea is the balance, 阴阳 balance. So the 阴阳 balance, how does it connect with our body?
所以我就用这张图来解释。
Okay, now look at this picture. It talks about the balance of your body.
这个锅子就是代表一个人的身体。
Well, if your body is this pot, this is your body. Yeah.
那这个水呢，就像我们就是我们的阴。
Water is the 阴。Water is 阴。
就像我们身体的营养物质
，It's like the nutrition inside your body.
是，下面这个火呢，就是阳。
The fire underneath, the fire burning the water, the fire is 阳。
这就是我们身体消化吸收，好、哦，开始产生能量。
This is the you digest nutrition and create energy. So this is the energy, and this is the blood.
然后上面。有水蒸气，这就是中医讲的气能量。
Okay, so the energy burning the nutrition, the blood, then it comes out the qi. Qi is the energy, the source of energy.
现在人身心有很多的问题，the root cause, 真正原因都还是在这两边的不平衡。
Okay, so the idea of our body, just think it as a pot and put on top of the fire.So you need to balance in the water, yang, and the fire. So if this is out of balance, then your body has some kind of problem.
所以现在的人呢，都吃的太多，但是运动的太少了。
Okay, so if you eat too much, then what is more? Yes, in, right? Nutrition, a lot, too many water, a lot of water.But if you don't do exercise, you don't have fire. And no fire, how can it burn the water? Then if you cannot burn the water, then what? No qi, no energy. So that's basically a very major problem is we eat too much, but we don't do exercise, right?
是的。
Yes. So this is the cause of a lot of problem. And our body, this...has this kind of yin and yang balance, and we are connected with the whole universe. So what about the universe? Does it have anything to do with our problem?
Yeah. 现在来介绍就是我们除了要自己健康之外，我们要知道人是小宇宙，那个天地是大宇宙。
Yeah, so Dr. Zhang told us that we are a small universe, and the whole universe is a bigger one.So we are just a small part of it. So, what should we do?
好，所以我们要了解每一个季节它的特性，然后我们来顺着季节来养生。
In addition to the yin and yang balance inside our body, we have to realize there's a yin yang balance of the universe. So it's according to different season.We have to take care of our body in different way. So the season, different season. So can you give us one example? How do we follow the season? Follow the season.
因为我们知道有冷跟热的平衡，跟阳光跟雨水的平衡。
See, in different season, we have the cold season, hot season, and we have the season with a lot of sunshine, season with a lot of rain. So the coldness in the heart is in yang balance. And the sunshine and the rain is also a balance. So,
for example, 我们看一下夏天。夏天我们刚刚过、yeah. 那我们知道夏天会有什么症状。
Yeah, so take summer as example. We are just passing summer.
夏天天气很热，湿气会重。
Yeah, in summertime it's so hot, very hot, right?
Yeah.
So wet inside our body.
那我们皮肤毛孔呢，就要排汗，让它顺利排汗，才不会中暑。
So we it's better that we can let the sweat go out. Yeah.
那这个时候我们大量吃冰。反而影响我们顺利排汗。我们想想看，我们吃冰是不是会凝结，不容易发汗
？Yeah, so a lot of people like to eat ice cream or drink icy water in summertime, and it's very cold. And cold is freeze together. So if you freeze your body, then it's not easy to sweat a lot, right?
所以啊，夏天啊。反而也容易感冒，因为你直接把冰吃进去，变肠胃型感冒了。
Wow, so you know why we always also catch cold in summer? Summer has no coldness outside. Why do we catch cold? Because we ate all this ice stuff, so it will cause the coldness inside our stomach.
所以啊，夏天更要 aware 我们冷气房进出的冷跟热，跟吃下去的冰东西跟热东西哦。
So that's in summertime, you have to be very careful about staying in the air conditioned room when you come out. Or if you eat too many icy water, then it's no good to your body.
Yeah.
So that's the, in the summertime, you have to be very careful. But I understand a lot of people really like to drink icy water. When you are young, you don't feel anything, right? Because I'm so hot and I want to eat ice. But when you are old, something will happen, right? Yeah, so...That's why a lot of people, they are out of shape because too many wetness accumulate inside their body. Okay, now let's talk about the human body balance, yin-yang balance, yeah. right? From the universe, then come back to our, how do we create our balance other than nutrition and exercise? Yeah, so.
所以我用这两张图解释。白天呢就是动，所以我们用平甩功、太极拳来帮助我们活动。
So you know that there's a system. There's a system. It's like a doctor of our body. The system controls the balance of our body. So during daytime, we call this autonomic nervous system. Autonomic nervous system. During daytime, you do exercise, do activity. And during nighttime?
到晚上的时候呢，其实我们就要放松，才能进入睡眠。
Yeah, so nighttime you need to relax. So the yin-yang balance of humans is controlled by this autonomic nervous system. And what does it work for us? This system, how does it work for us? Let's look at this picture.
这是动态的太极阴阳的平衡，就是随时动静的平衡。
Yeah, so the system is working all the time, try to balance our body.
是，那我们现在人的白天呢，就是需要交感神经的启动。
So the autonomic nervous system has this one, sympathetic nervous system.
它可以帮助我们血液、集中，然后呢工作专心。
Okay, this sympathetic nervous system take care of action and move and run, and it can concentrate your blood, make it.Can concentrate and do a lot of work. So daytime is very active.
但是过头的话呢，就会造成我们紧张跟压力了。
Yeah, but if this system, the sympathetic system, is too active, then you will feel pressured.
所以，那另外一个自律神经的就是副交感神经，它就可以帮助我们放松。
So the other autonomic nervous system is the parasympathetic nervous system. And this system is trying to relax you, right?
对，这本来我们可以自然平衡的。
Originally, it should be automatic balance because it's the automatic system. It should be automatically create the balance.
是， 但是现在人工作压力大，很多时候把压力跟疲劳都带回家了，所以回家都不能放松了。
Wow, so, but nowadays we work in a very pressure life. So a lot of people, they bring this pressure during daytime and bring it home. So what's the situation?
所以呢，这张图呢，就是解释交感神经啊，就是油门，副交感神经就是刹车。
Yeah, so if we regard our body as a car,The sympathetic nervous system is like accelerator. Go, go, go. Push, push, push. And parasympathetic nervous system is like a brake. Say, stop, stop, stop. So basically, it should be balanced automatically, right? But nowadays, what happens is, it's not automatic balance.
现在我们大部分人都是这样，随时的油门跟刹车没办法平衡，一直都是油门多，刹车少。
Yeah, so nowadays people have too much accelerator, put too much power, and even bring the power back home, so they cannot have brakes. They don't rest at all. So this sympathetic nervous system works too much, then you are out of balance. And that's the basic reason. So how do we treat this situation if you have this kind of problem?
对，就是。So,要放松，放心，放心。
So the, we come back to 平衡 right? Remember, today our topic is 平衡 insomnia. So if you have this problem, you're already out of balance. You cannot fall asleep. That's because your nervous system is not on the balanced way. So this comes to Dr. Lee's, Master Lee's 心法, the 师父's words. He said, the more you let go, the more you can pick up later. So you have toRemember, the more you let go, the more you can pick up later. You don't have to pick up any time. You have to try to learn how to let go.
是。
Yeah. So, in order to have good sleep, what should you do?
好，这个呢，就是白天我们动，那我们活动跟劳动不一样哦。劳动是肌肉紧绷的，那我们练平甩功是放松的。
Yeah. So, in order to have good sleep,During daytime, you need to find some time to do gentle exercise, such as 平甩。
是，那到晚上放松的时候呢，在睡前如果我们能静坐呢，做个 meditation、哦、其实也可以有助于我们入眠哦。
At night time, it's not just lie down, you can do some gentle meditation, then it will also help you sleep well. Well.Very good. So during daytime, we do 平甩, and during nighttime, we do meditation, and it will help create the balance. And it talk about if you cannot sleep well, because the meridian, Chinese medicine always talk about meridian system. So meridian system, what is it to do? How does 平甩 help with the smooth of meridian system?
Okay. 所以刚刚讲到了，你有没有发现？一个药物真的能解决睡觉的问题吗？我们身体有这么多原因造成诶。
Yeah, so can one medicine cure all these problems? You see, the sleeping problem is created by different organs. Can one medicine cure? Can, yeah.
所以我们要回到平衡，有一个最简单的方法，就是用中医的阴阳平衡跟气血平衡来做到。
So,Doctors say that that's why we come back to the basic. It's the balance, the ideal balance. If you can bring the blood and the fire and the yin and yang to create a balance, then if your body is balanced, then it can gently solve the problem.
是啊，所以动静阴阳平衡，气血一平衡，我们就恢复到我们的 natural 的 status 了。
Yes, if you have the balance, then you will become natural. So the qi, the 平甩 create the qi. Qi is like the meridian system is like the qi highway of your body. So the PS workout will help you clear the traffic jam. And if you can clear all the traffic jam, then your body, the traffic is smooth, and then you will feel good. You will feel balanced. That's why 平甩 can work with...all this sleeping problem. So now let's review what we talk about today. So can you answer these questions? Question to you. If you describe your body as a car, accelerator is what system? And brake is which system? Can you answer that question? Yeah, I believe you can. Okay, so today we got all these idea about the yin-yang balance. And people sometimes ask, you say that the Ping Shui can help us sleep.
Yeah.
But some people, they say, I do Ping Shui before I go to bed, but I feel so energetic, I cannot fall asleep. What should I do?
Okay, 确实平甩睡前平甩呢有两种状况，一种是很快就可以睡，一种人是精神反而更好。
Yeah, there are two kind of situation will happen is some people after they do PS workout, they do fall asleep right away because they feel relaxed. But some people, they cannot fall asleep because they feel energetic. So what should we do if I cannot sleep?
是，好，第一个呢就是我先解释为什么，因为、
yeah.
它能量够的时候，它在帮我们消除疲劳，正在消除疲劳。
Uh-huh. Yeah, the reason that you cannot fall asleep is because you have enough energy, and the energy is trying to get rid of the exhaust qi, the tiredness, to get rid of all this bad stuff outside of your body.
所以这个时候练完之后，不要立刻去睡。
Yeah, so if you have this kind of situation.After the PS workout, you don't need to go to bed right away.
所以不妨在床上做一下心里默念的师父的心法，放松、放心、放下。
So you can sit on your bed for a while, and you concentrate in your mind. You can tell yourself, relax, take it easy, let go. You just continually tell yourself, relax.Take easy, let it go, and sit for a while, then go to bed.
这就是自我引导的一个很好的方式。
This is a self-guidance to guide your body to relax, to take easy, to let go.
Yeah.
Very good. Okay, so what if after this I still cannot sleep?
哦，但还有很多人跟我说，我知道，但我做不到，我就是放松不了，事情一堆。
Yeah, some people told Dr.Say that, I know I have to relax, but I just cannot. I have so many things in my mind. What should I do?
是，那我分享、哦、李凤山师父的静坐导引很有用哦。
Yeah, so Dr. Zhang recommend Master Li's guided meditation CD. This is really good because it's 师父 Master Li's voice inside this guided meditation. It's very efficient.It can bring your brainwave to a stable one, then you may fall asleep easily.
是，它可以帮助到两种状况的人。
Yes.
第一种状况就是没办法入眠，那他听师父的静坐导引，听着听着呢就可以睡着了。
Yeah, some people if they cannot sleep and they listen to the CD, and then they just easily, naturally fall asleep.
同样的，有另一种状况是忧郁症的人。
Oh, and some people who have the depression problem.
那他用药产生了很多副作用。
Yeah, and because the medication created a lot of side effect.
那这么多的 side effect, 吃了一个药产生另外一个 side effect, 好，那怎么办呢？其实我也有一个经验，我帮助一个忧郁症的人，然后他听师父的静坐导引，他最后停药了。
Wow, he really helped someone who had a depression problem, and.That person eventually stopped using medication.
对
What's the method? 用什么方法？
就是听师父的静坐导引。
哦，
因为心事放不下，想太多。师父告诉我们，太多事情放不下。那听师父的静坐导引，在听的那段时间，他完全的放空，完全的跟着师父的导引，他反而体会到真正的放松，他就渐渐停药了。
Well, so he used the CD.To help the patient, and because he listened carefully, so he gradually just get rid of all these thoughts inside her mind, and then she can eventually fall asleep. Good. Well, thank you, Dr. Zhang. We spent a lot of time realizing the idea behind insomnia and Ping Shui, and now it's really time for us to a little bit.Short Ping Shui. Are you ready? Now let's do Ping Shui and concentrate on what? Relax, let go, take it easy. Okay, relax, take it easy and let go. Everybody, get ready for Ping Shui. If you can stand up, please stand up.
Okay.
If you cannot stand up, then you can sit down like me. And then we will do the Ping Shui. If you want to know a little bit more about the detail of how to do Ping Shui, you can watch our previous episode. Okay, now stand with your feet apart with each other, shoulder width. Very good. And take it easy. Slow down your breathing. Close your eyes. Very good. And when you feel comfortable, now open your eyes. Good. Let's raise your hand to shoulder height. When you listen to the number, then you start to swing your arms. Let's go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Very good.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Good. Remember, relax.
1, 2, 3.
Take it easy.
5.
Let go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Good.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Create balance.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Remember to put a smile on your face.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
That can make you relax more.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1,
swing for balance.
2, 3, 4, 5. 1,
swing
two,
for regularity.
3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Swing for happiness.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Good.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Wonderful.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
10 minutes a day. Keep your doctor away.
4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Very good.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1,
swing for balance.
3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Relax.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Take it easy.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Very good.
5. 1.
Let go
2,
of everything.
3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, three, four, five.
Very good.
One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. One,
good.
Two,
concentrate.
Three, four, five.
Okay,
one,
very good.
Two,
now let's slowly,
three,
slowly
four,
stop.
Five.
Close your eyes
one,
for a while.
Two,
relax. Three, breathe slowly. Breathe gently. Breathe deeply. Very good. Okay, now open your eyes. Move your legs a little bit. Thank you. Good exercise. Wow, very good. You know, what happens is some people when they do ping shuai, if they are very, very tired, even when they are swinging their arm, they start to fall asleep. That's what happened to me.
Yeah.
But I still do. I still do. Even I'm fall asleep, then I still continue. Because 30 minutes a day, right? Minimum. So we need to practice for at least 30 minutes. Yeah. Can you tell us, there's a question from Chang Ji from Malaysia. And he's asking, what is yin and yang? Well, that is a question. What is yin and yang? Yin and yang. Well, you know, about yin yang, people can write a big book. So, make big book become small book.
yin and yang.
Yin
and yang. Yin 就是可以看作是血，阳就是气。
Well, if we talk about our body, yin is the
血
blood. Yang
就是气
is your qi. The blood and qi inside your body is yin and yang. So when we say yin yang balance, that means your blood and qi has to be balanced. And blood comes from nutrition, right? Blood comes from nutrition. And qi comes from what? Exercise, right? What exercise is a good exercise? Good. Ping shuai exercise.
Yeah.
Very good. Okay. If you think you already understand yin and yang, and you think that you want Dr. Zhang to come back again, you can give us a super sticker, super reward in YouTube, okay? Okay, now the second question from Germany. Timothy from Germany, hi. And Timothy from Germany asks, how long after Ping Shuai workout can we see or feel the good effect on solving sleeping problem? 就是练Ping Shuai多久以后可以看到我睡眠改善了呢？
哦，每个人的身体状况不一样，所以累积的疲劳程度不一样，会时间的长短也不一样。
Because everyone has different kind of sleeping disorder, different kind of body situation, and it depends on how you do Ping Shuai workout. So you cannot say how long. It's really hard to give you an exact answer. But can you give us some kind of example? 可不可以给一点例子
？Okay. 比如说一年有失眠问题的人，他大概练一个月的话，他会有大幅度的改善。
Well, real example, if you have sleeping problem about 1 year, then maybe after 1 month, you will feel a great improvement on your sleeping quality. Well, that's a good news, right? If you already have 1 year sleeping problem, it will take you about 1 month, and you can improve. But how long do you have to do PS workout every day in order to have improvement within 1 month?每天要练多久才能够一个月就有改善呢？
每天至少练一次的30分钟哦。
Well, at least you have to do PS workout 30 minutes a day once. At least, then you can see improvement within 1 month. Okay, so Timothy, I hope whoever had this kind of problem, please tell them 1 month can help you recover this sleeping problem. The next one, Next one is from Malaysia. And Mr. Zhang, S.L. Zhang, Malaysia asks, there are so many schools all over the world to teach meditation. How to do meditation exercise Meimen way? 他问说，哎，这么多都在教静坐，那梅门的静坐是什么呢？
OK， 李凤山师父教我们的静坐，它是直接我们放松放心放下就可以达到 不用有意识的导引的方式，因为外面的很多是用意识导引的，它也比较有风险性，师父给我们的方法是最安全最有效的。
OK， so Meimen way, you know that Meimen means no door, right? So Meimen way is no way. No way means a Meimen way is you simply sit, relax, take it easy,Let go. You simply sit down and try to relax yourself. And remember what Dr. Zhang said, if you cannot relax yourself, listen to Master Li's voice. So in other schools, there are different kinds of meditation. And sometimes it make you a little bit nervous to do that. So Meimen way, so at the beginning, you may count down the medication, guided meditation CD.You need to use the CD to help you calm down. But after a while, you can really let go of that CD too.
Right.
Yeah, everything just let go. You can easily fall asleep. So meditation has to plus PS workout together.
Yeah.
Two together make better effect. Okay. The next is Ian from Philippines. Ian from Philippines, he asked, If we take an example of PS workout and meditation, can we say PS workout means yang and meditation means yin? 我们可以说，如果我们把平甩跟静坐来讲的话，那是不是平甩就是阳，静坐就是阴呢？可以这样讲吗？ Can we say that?
Okay. 这样的理解很好。
Yeah, this is a very good understanding.Yeah, so is it okay?
This 是可以的。那再深一层呢？其实，阳中有阴，阴中有阳。
Well, your understanding is all right, but actually, within the yang, there's also yin. Within the yin, there's also yang. So, what about the 平甩 is the yang? So the yang, there's yin inside. What is the yin in 平甩?
For example, 就是。在平甩的过程中，第一个先带动到是全身循环，那就是阳，带动气。
So when you do 平甩 it create the 气 circulation, that's 阳。
但是你练到20分钟以上，你有那个 tempo 了，你进入了动中禅，就是进入了放松的境况。
So after 20 minutes of PS workout, then you gradually move into a kind of very regular movement,very stabilized, and that is yang, that's yin, right?
Yeah, yin.
The balanced, the regular tempo. Yeah.
所以身体
you feel relaxed.
外面在动，心反而更平静。这个有很多医院来实验。
Yeah. So the outside is on the go, yang, but the inside is very stabled, very calm, and that's yin. So that's why we say 平甩is yin inside yang.
Yeah,
right, very good.
Right,
what about meditation? Meditation is yang inside yin. Right?
Meditation, 大家看到都是静在那边，会认为是yin.
Yeah, a lot of people think that you sit there, you are so calm, then that's yin.
对，
yeah.
那yin中有阳就是我们的 mind, 我们的 思想它会产生能量。
Well, the yang inside meditation is your mind will create energy while you are doing meditation. So that is the yang. Wow, that is a good understanding. Thank you for your question. Then we also realize PS workout and meditation, they both are yin yang balance.
Yeah.
Right? Very good. So we thank you for Andy Su, your donation. Thank you for your donation. Andy is our...super fan.
Oh,
yeah, he always donates. Thank you, Andy.
Thank you.
We love you. And also, a very, very loyal fans also added 20 Hong Kong dollars. Thank you for your donations. Thank you. We really need your donation to support our program to let this program go on, go on, and go on. So thank you, all of you. Okay, the question number five is from Fook Chow Young. Fook Chow Young. And is asked, does PS workout help improve the heart and the prostate problem? 对于这个射护线好还有我们的心脏那频甩它有帮助吗
哦，第一个讲心脏它有绝对的帮助比如说高血压的人练习频甩你可以试试看练前跟练后去量一下血压你就知道咯
Well, PS workout really help your blood pressure if you have blood pressure problem you can check your pressure before and after PS then you will understand how PS workout
那为什么对心脏有频甩对心脏有帮助呢
Yeah, why does it help? Why does 频甩 work with your heart?
血压高就是因为身体的含氧量不够
Because if you have high blood pressure that means you don't haveenough oxygen inside your body.
所以要加压加速循环。
So you need to accelerate your circulation.
当你放松的时候血管也放松了然后身体含氧量也多了。
So when you are relaxed, then your blood vessel also relax, your oxygen will increase.
所以你的血压也会下降。
So your blood pressure will lower down. So PS workout is make you relax.、
Right? 这也是现在人的文明的问题所以造成我们过度紧张频甩功就可以解决这件事情。
Yeah, because nowadays we live in a very pressure world and so much pressure. So we have so many anxious anxiety inside our body. So everything is so tense. But PS, 频甩 can help you relax, take it easy and let go.、Yeah.
所以频甩、高血压是症状不是疾病哦。
Oh, so Dr. John told us that the blood pressure is a symptom, it's not the disease itself.
持续练习频甩功让身体放松、哦、血液循环变好你就可以不用一辈子依赖药哦。
Yeah, so if you do PS workout every day, it can improve your circulation, balance your yin yang, then maybe someday you do not need to rely on medication anymore. What about the prostate problem?
第二个问题就是那个射护线、
前列腺、射护线。
射护线是男性在中年以后都会有的普遍问题。
But a lot of, especially male, they after they 40 years old, they usually have this kind of problem, the prostate problem.
是，那也是在中医看也是因为我们的气血循环不良造成。我们的射护线没办法收放所以造成一些排尿的问题
Well, so it comes back to the balance idea because our circulation is no good so it cannot get rid of all the bad stuff that's why it creates problem
所以频甩功增加我们身体的气血循环也可以有效的改善为什么我们处在五下要蹲一下那个蹲一下就可以帮助我们把气血往下走
OkSo, the PS workout helps the circulation, especially remember, on the fifth count, what we do is we bend down our knees, gently bounce twice. So this move, this fifth move, can actually bring all the qi and blood downward, so can improve the circulation of your lower body. So that's very important, so you have to do it in the right way. Yeah,
right.
Very good. Okay, so, Okay, another question. Well, another question. Another question is from Indonesia. Trio from Indonesia. Yes. Trio asks, while doing PS workout, sometimes I can feel warm in my lower abdominal. What does it mean? 他说他练平甩有时候会觉得，这个下腹部这个地方就有点暖和和的，这是什么意思啊？
暖和和的。练习平甩每个人的感觉都不一样那他你下部腹暖和和的就是这个地方它需要很多的 energy 气血能量所以它集到那里去帮你打通那边的循环哦
Okay, so if you feel warm there that means everybody will feel differently but if you feel warm here that means when you are doing the PS workout, this part of your body is accumulate energy. So energy is accumulated here, and it is trying to do something with your body. So that's a good thing. Don't worry. So, but everyone will feel differently. It's not necessary that you have this situation and another person has the same situation. No, it's not necessary. Mm-hmm. Everyone will feel different. But we can understand that the warmness is the qi and the blood. Okay? Good. Continue. And the second, the seventh question is John Kumari. John Kumari asks, I am a heart bypass patient. Is 贫血 safe for me? 他可能有心导管的这个做过手术，绕动脉的手术。那贫血是安全的吗
？OK， 心导管手术。
So you have operation, right?
心导管手术因为有外面的东西，所以我们需要还要配合饮食的清淡哦。
Yeah, so if you have operation with your heart, you have this kind of problem, and in addition, of course, you can do 贫血 in a gentle way, but in addition to 贫血, you really need to watch out for your diet. You need to eat a little bit light.
第一个贫血绝对就没有问题，对，有这个，因为它很放松，所以帮助循环。才不会让心导管阻塞。
Yes, so PS workout is very gentle exercise. If you do it in a gentle way and relaxed way, actually it improves the circulation. So it won't let this vessel around your heart block again, can clear the bypass.
还要一点提醒的哦。就是YouTube 上也有。美国总统前总统克林顿他也特别提醒他之前呢换过四根导管他说不是换了就没事了
Well, Dr. Clinton, previous American President Clinton, he had heart operation. He changed the four channels here, but it doesn't mean that the problem went away.
他换了四根导管之后，他想要不要再换了，所以他就开始素食。他在 YouTube 上接受新闻媒体的介绍，他讲他素食之后，他的导管就很干净，就不用再清了。
Well, ex President Clinton, he had the heart operation four times, and he didn't want to do it anymore. So he changed his diet to become a vegetarian.And after he changed his diet to become vegetarian, and the doctor find out that his heart, the vessels, the tube, is all clean, very clean. So diet is really important. 饮食很重要。
很重要。
Yeah, about your heart. Okay, so next question, if you have more questions, you are welcome to post the question on our YouTube channel.And you can send in all your questions to us. We will answer your question. And, well, next episode, we are going to invite Dr. Zhang again. And he is also going to talk about how 贫血 help increase your immune system, increase your self-recovery ability. And remember, you have to sign up.With this program and click on the bell, push on the bell. Then if we have new episode, it will remind you. So when you sign up with our program, click on the little bell on the bottom. So it will receive notice from us. Okay? Okay. So today is a very special day that we have to use a Chinese.And the English all together, and I hope that it won't bother you. And the basic idea is yin and yang has to be balanced. And relax, take easy, and let go. And I hope you get something from today's program. And we looking forward to see you next time. Thank you, Dr. Zhang. Thank you,
everybody. Thank you, everybody. See you next time.
See you next time. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.